Hey everybody, Prepper Nurse One here. Today is Tuesday, August 4th, 2020. So I want to do a basically overview of everything that we're going to do here with the solar system. What we're going to be changing, what's going to be updated, how we're going to do it. Now, if you're looking at my solar rack out here, what you probably noticed, these six are the same, the next four are the same, and the last five are the same. Each one of these is different, okay? We have 15 panels total on this solar rack. All right? These panels here are 250-watt panels. All right? The next four are 255-watt panels, and the last five are 300-watt panels. So what ends up happening, these six are on the one system, okay, which was the system that always brings in the lowest amount of solar. These nine are on the other system. So what happens with that? All right. So what happens is the 300-watt panels are not pulling in 300 watts. They reduce down to the level of the 255-watt panels. So that being on that side, it's only all of them, even though they're 300-watt panels, are only pulling in the 255. Okay. So what we're going to end up doing here, we're going to be changing everything. So my total system, not counting these 300-watt panels, which are separate, those 300-watt panels go over to the camper on the other side of the property, Brian's camper, and they charge up batteries that he has in there. It's a completely different thing for him there. But we're going to talk about these 15 panels. So these 15 panels, it's a total system of 4,020 watts. So what am I going to be doing? So the game plan is, I am going to change out all 15 of these panels. I can pick up 400-watt panels for like $200 right now each. So I'm going to pick up, I'm going to get 15 400-watt panels, which will give us a 6,000-watt solar system. So what we're going to end up doing, and I'm going to show you inside, we're going to go into the battery room in a moment, and I'm going to talk about what we're going to be doing there, what's been going on, and what we're going to be correcting, okay? But if you get everything the same, they're all going to pull their right amount of power, okay? So let's go inside the battery room. I wanted to start out here so that you could see that first, and, you know, why things are doing what they're doing out there, and then we're going to go in here. All right, so let me turn this on. All right, so yes, we've continued to have issues with the solar system. The main reason why we're having issues, and I'm going to put it up here like this so you can see this. These Midnight Classics are designed for like lead acid, those type of batteries. They're not designed for the lithium ion batteries. Alright, so I have the new charge controllers. It's going to be a combination. It has the inverter let's see if you can see. Yeah, you can see the inverter over here. The inverter and the charge controller all in one system. Alright, so I have two of those. So what we're going to end up doing is each one of those systems can handle 2,000 watts. So what we're going to be doing in the meantime, for the short term, we're going to put the six solar panels on one of those systems, the nine panels on the other system, okay? Then that way we will have, you know, more than enough and then we're going to break them up. So the one with the nine panels for right now are going to go on the one system that I'm going to use for my place. Then the other one is going to be the system that's going to be for my sister's house, because people have been asking me, what are you going to do? How are you going to do it with that? Okay. So what we'll end up doing is, for right now, let me go back down here so you can see these. Three of the batteries are going to be used for my house. Two of the batteries are going to be for my sister's house for right now. I'm going to be ordering three more of these batteries as well. So once I order three more batteries, four will go for my house, four will go for my sister's house. Now obviously they're not in their house yet. They've been staying out here and working on stuff. They don't have their whole electrical system wired up yet. But
So we're going to have two different systems, because we have, let me just, actually let me do this real quick, and I will show you guys what I'm talking about. So, hold on a second, guys. I'm going to pull this out so you can see it, so that way you have an idea of what I'm talking about while I'm doing this. Hold on one second. I'm going to get this out of here first so that you can see it. So tomorrow, Brian is coming tomorrow, okay? So I'm going to turn this around. So this is an MPP solar system, okay? This one here is designed, it's a charge controller and an inverter all in one. And that's designed to be able to handle the lithium ion batteries. So again, the part of the issue is we're having over here, it's not reading properly, okay? So even though we're bringing power in, it's not getting to where it needs to go. We are having issues with that. So what we're gonna do, okay? So these systems here, this one here, and then I have another one, so I have two of them. One will be for my house, okay? One will be for my sister's house. And so we're gonna do that and get those set up for, you know, so those are gonna go on the wall here. We're gonna leave these up here right now. These are gonna be disconnected for the moment, okay? So the way that we're gonna do it, when the new panels come in, five panels will go for my sister's house, five panels will go for my house, which leaves another five panels. So we're gonna be going from a 4,000 watt system to a 6,000 watt system. The last 2,000 watts, I will end up having down the road here. I'm gonna have to buy another one of these, okay? And then that third 2,000 watts will go for the greenhouse. So we will have all that set up from the solar rack for all of those. Now, I am still going to have, I'm gonna put this back to that point. I'm still going to have all these other solar panels, right? So what am I gonna do? I still have my old batteries, all right? So I have 12 of these batteries, which will make 324 volt batteries. So what the game plan is going to be, once we get everything in, everything is set up, everything is separated, I get the third unit in here as well for the greenhouse. So the greenhouse will also have its own system of power over there. What I'm planning on doing is I will take, and these will stay in here, because, well, actually the MPPs, you know, the probably like one there, one will go over there, one will be over here, something like that. I'm not sure how we'll do it. We'll put a third one in here as well, okay? That will be for strictly for the greenhouse. So then I will have all these solar panels that I'm pulling off. So I'm going to be pulling off 15 solar panels, and I'm going to have 12 batteries that I'm not using. Now, I will have these two inverters to use, and then, these two charge controllers to use, and this inverter. What I plan on doing, all right, I'll probably move these, all right, and they, down the road, will go in, probably into the chicken coop, or I'll have something outside on the end, I'll build something outside so it's there. The batteries will go out there, and then I will have some solar panels, some of those solar panels, used to power up the chicken coop. And so that, I think, is what we're going to end up doing, something like that. Or also possibly when my sister's shed gets in here, that we may wire it up to make sure that we got enough power for the shed as well. So that extra stuff that we're going to have will be utilized to either power up. Probably what I'm going to do is,
I can always break that up too. It doesn't have to be a certain way. I have another inverter still in the shop that from before. It's one that I picked up at Tractor Supply. It's like a 2,000 or 3,000 watt inverter. So what I could do is I could take part of the system and use it for there. Like I could take, basically if I took four batteries, did a 24 volt, like one 24 volt battery for the chicken coop and set that there, and then do another one for my sister's building and use the other eight batteries that I'm going to have, you know, the extra batteries that I have, Trojan L16E batteries. I can put them over there so we can have power in that building. We'll have power for the chickens, and you know, and then we'll have enough power for my sister's house, my house, and also the greenhouse. I will just have to figure out what we're going to do. So basically the battery room is going to be for my sister's house, my house, and the greenhouse. All right. All of those panels will be on this rack. So we're going to be going from a 4,000 watt system to a 6,000 watt system, broken up into three, and that should give us more than enough power. And if we have, like I said, with the batteries, once I get three more batteries as well, we'll have more than enough for everything. And so that's going to be the game plan and for right now. And we're going to see how that works out, and we're going to go from there. But, yeah, it'll all come together. It's just, you know, everything has to, we got to get the bugs worked out. Like I said, Brian is coming tomorrow. He's going to change those out, and we're going to, hopefully, that's going to address the issue that we're having in here. Because that charge controller and that inverter, you know, well, the charge controllers especially are not designed for lithium iron batteries. So they're designed for like a lead acid battery or a marine deep cycle battery, because that's what I've used in the past with them, and that worked fine. You know, this change has definitely, you know, affected things. So we're basically, what we're working out, guys, is we're working out the bugs. Once we get the bugs worked out and get this squared away, you know, with these new batteries, we should be absolutely good to go. So got to make a few changes, and that'll be a good thing. So we had a lot of rain earlier. Now that the sun is out a little bit right now, so I mean, you can look at the leaves and see the leaves are wet, but like, look at there, see the water standing there. Now with putting this new stone down through here, you can even actually see kind of wet right there in that one spot, but it's all underneath the stone, which is great, because that's where we would have an issue. It would be just a muddy mess through here. So, you know, even over here, you can see some standing water. I have to put more stone through here. I'm obviously going to put more stone through this area as well. But, you know, so that's what's going on there. But, so that is the game plan with the solar. And so, you know, it's just trying to get things squared away, get things fixed. You know, the power situation, of course, is a number one thing, especially when you are in an off-grid system. You have to have things working properly and working smoothly. With the new batteries, we should be rocking and rolling. And like I said, I think it's once we switch over to the other charge controller and inverter, I think it's going to make a difference, and we should be good to go. So that's the game plan. We're going to see how that works. I'm going to order the new panels, so when they get here, we will change those out, and so that'll be interesting as well. And then I'm going to have to store, for the meantime, I'm going to have to take these 15 panels off and figure out where we're going to store them, how we're going to do this, you know, how are we going to set up for, like, the chicken coop and stuff like that. I mean, one option that I can think of that we could do, realistically, and it would work, would be to come around the front side of my sister's property. And this would be, again, this would be for the chicken coop, okay? We could put a pole over on this side somewhere. I mean, it wouldn't really matter where we put that pole. You know, we could stick it over in this area even if we wanted to. Get that up higher than the roof of the, you know, the new place, and have that there. And again, it's going to catch all that sunshine, and then we could use that power that way. So if I put 6 or 9 of the you know, panels up there, and had that power either, you know, running to my sister's or running to the chicken coop, you know, we can even break it up, you know what I mean? It doesn't, you know, or if I wanted to put 12 panels up, you know, put an another, but then that would entail, like, you know, here, here, and here, you know, for that part of it. So we would, we'll have to see. We'll have to figure it all out, but we'll get it figured out. I'm not exactly sure how we're going to do that. Those would be things down the road. Okay, we don't have to have power to the chicken coop anytime soon. We don't need to have power to my sister's storage building anytime soon. So, you know, we will have the panels, we'll have the inverters, we'll have the charge controllers for all that when we're ready to do that, which would be huge savings. But, you know, like I said, we'll figure everything out and it will all come together. But so that's where we're at. That's what's going on here at the homestead. So I was trying to get some things figured out today. Like I said, Brian is coming tomorrow. So I will show you everything going on with that. Oh, I wanted to show you the caps that I did have. I put on here. Okay, so, and then I need 4 more. All right, because that's all, those ones are all on there as well now. But, so that's what it's going to look like when they're all capped. I'm probably going to have to go back because it was raining today. I didn't feel like going to get any other end caps. So I will wait and get the rest of the end caps. So tomorrow, because I was motivated and I'm stubborn, what I did yesterday, and I hadn't planned on doing it all yesterday, but I ended up doing it all yesterday. I was just going to move over the... I just want to walk over here and show you this. I was just going to bring over the base stones, okay? So there's 24 of those, and then I knew that I was going to need 24 of the concrete blocks. So I brought over like the first 4 of the concrete blocks and said, okay, you know, once I bring the, you know, I was bringing them over 2 at a time. So once I bring these over, you know, I did the 4. And then I'm like, well, I'll probably do the rest tomorrow. I ended up going up and seeing Greg and dropping off some eggs for Greg. I came back and I was like, it's 6 o'clock. I'll do some more. Well, I ended up doing it all. So all 24 blocks are here. All 24 of the stones are here. We are ready for the building to go in. I went down and talked with them today. And they will be delivering the building next Monday. So again, all I'm going to have to do at this point is I'm going to rake this back a little bit so it's more of a sloped so they can get it up here easier. And that's pretty much it. And we're going to be ready to go. But we're going to tuck that in there as much as we can. And then so, you know, there'll be extra footage on this end. So that's not going to be an issue at all. But so that's where we're at. So hopefully tomorrow we'll take care of our issues with the solar system, with putting the new charge controllers and inverter in, and we're gonna separate the systems at that point, so that when they do finish getting their electrical in, that you know, we will. I guess that guy's coming next week, and then they have to have their final inspection on the electric, because you have 2 of them. You have the rough one done, and then you have your final inspection done. So once that is squared away and done, then we're ready to just plug their system in, and they'll be ready to go. Of course, I'm ringing. Oh, let's see. And lo and behold, guys, guess who it is? It's Mom. What a shock. So, but anyway, somebody had asked in the comments the other day, and I wanted to address it really quickly. Did I have to get a permit for this building? Yes, I had to get a permit for this building. Anything larger than an 8x12, you have to have a permit for. So, I mean, the permit for the building, guys, is $25. So, again, anybody that was thinking about calling the town and saying, he's doing this and he's doing that and he's doing the other thing. Everything is above board. Everything is legal. So don't waste your time. Because if you call them, which go ahead, knock yourselves out, everything is legal. So there you go. So we want to make sure that, you know, people that hate us, which are our few, you know, that there's nothing you can do. So everything is legal. So there we go. You know, it's a game that has to be played. So we're playing the game the way it's supposed to be played. So I did get the permit for this building. Like I said, the building will be here next Monday. You know, and so we are ready for the building. And that's what, before I knew that the building was coming, I wanted to have this set up and be ready, and now we are. So anyway, so that's it for now, guys. I am going to jump off of here, and so I hope that kind of explains what we're doing with the solar system. Yes, it's going to cost more money, but we're going to have the extra, you know, wattage to work with, and then we're also going to have, you know, extra solar panels to utilize for other projects. So, you know, we're going to go from having the availability of 4,000 watts total, right now we're at 4,020 watts available, to, you know, having 6,000 watts up on the rack itself alone, and having another 4,000 watts that we can utilize wherever we want to. So that's going to give us a grand total of 10,000 watts that we can utilize for the homestead, which is going to be more than enough for all of our needs here to take care of everything that we need to take care of. So, you know, and with putting up brand new panels, it's going to make things better as well. So anyway, it'll be more efficient, okay? I mean, these other panels are fine. They'll continue to work for the next 25 to 30 years. So, you know, I mean, it's not like they're going to run out and all of a sudden go bad. All right, so that's what's happening. That's where we're at. We're going to continue to get things done, and things are coming together. So any questions, please feel free in the comments. Please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you are not subscribed. I'm hoping everybody's doing very, very well. I hope your week is starting well, and I hope everybody's safe. You know, it's already Tuesday, so, you know, it just the time is just flying by, guys. And before we know it, it's going to be winter again. And, you know, there's going to, of course, there's always something else to do. But we're going to try to continue to do as much as we can before the winter gets here, and we're going to go from there. So anyway, remember, guys, hug and kiss the ones you love. Tell them every single day. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. We never know what's going to happen in life. So it's really important to tell the people that you care about every single day how you feel. Also remember STD. It's one step at a time, one thing at a time, and one day at a time. Whatever you are trying to do, whatever you are trying to accomplish, you can do it. The only one that's going to stop you from reaching those goals is you. Nobody else can stop you. Stay positive, stay away from that negativity, and you're going to be fine. Also remember, we are all in this together. That is important to remember because it is so true. All right? I will talk to you all later. I hope everybody has a great day. Prepper Nurse One, out for now.